All right, YouTube, today we're doing another VOD session. This time we're breaking down the LAT versus Seattle hardpoint terminal. We're gonna be looking at the final three hardpoint hills of the map. It was a back and forth game, and you'll see that in these next few hills. And Seattle's able to pull away in the final P5. So we're gonna be breaking down all those situations going into those three hills, talk about it, and breaking everything down for you guys. So let's get right into it. All right, so we're gonna start with this P3 rotation over here. This was coming off of a P2 where Seattle actually had a good rotation to it. Unfortunately though, they did get broken on in, so you'll see that LAT is holding this 18 seconds of scrap time. Seattle here is rotated early at new. You'll see they have number 5 and number 7. They're double channeling this front side plane for anyone that might be trying to break through the front. Then you have number 6 here, who's a Abuza. He's gonna be watching out for this outer window or anyone who might be taking some type of outer route, you know, down these terminal stairs. So everything on this left side of the map is covered for. And then you'll see number 8 over here. He just spawns out towards this Esky side, and he most likely is gonna go up to the top 3rd position and fill that position in for that team so that they can watch the other hallways or anything on this other side of the map. So as you see, we're playing it out here. You know, LAT doesn't have to challenge anything right away. They're just gonna wait for each other and push together. And Alec here in the number 8 position actually chooses just to stay in this corner watching his own Eskies, because he probably thinks that he can't get up to the top 3rd in time for, you know, number 2 and number 3 to see him and start killing him off of that position. And so what he chooses to do is basically just watch this entire right side of the map for his team. You know, he's cutting off Eskies. He's cutting off anyone who might jump out over here. He's cutting off anyone who's, you know, might be going through bottom red towards the slide over here. So he's cutting off this entire right side of the map, making sure that his team only has to watch, you know, the cockpit chow from anyone that's coming through terminal. So they have the whole map covered for this hold. And it's actually a pretty decent play because he probably thought that he wouldn't be able to get up to top 3. So he's still cutting the map in another position. So as you see, LAT is going to try and break on in here together. They have 2 seconds left. He just killed a trophy. So he's going to try and nade cockpit here just to see if there's anyone playing in this position, because if there is, he's going to have to hard clear it. If not, then he can try and take another channel in a different way. And what he's going to actually see is that number 3 Cammy is going to die to number 6 Abuza. He's actually top halls over here, but from this outer position, Abuza can see that. So Afro is going to get this trade right away on Abuza. That's one part of this hold that is cleared for LAT now. And now they're going to try and bang out this front side of the plane together. They're double channeling it. Unfortunately though, this team channel, it's just so hard to play against if they're on the same page. And what do you know, Kyler and Illy are able to get 2 kills. Kyler actually gets traded by Dan Ghosty here. He's last alive in this push, but unfortunately for them, that's just not enough. He's not going to be able to get this final kill on a chow that he has to take pretty much on Ender, because if he wins that gunfight, he's going to be able to, you know, actually soak some time and just at least get them off the point for a little bit and gain some time for his reinforcements, you know, number 3 coming through the stream side over here. So if he was able to make that time white, it'll be a little bit better. But as you'll see here, as soon as the push starts coming in, Alec finally makes his way towards this top 3rd area because he knows that he can try and take some space now that they got, like, you know, 1 or 2 kills. And now you can see he's in a prime position to do a wall bang that a lot of teams are starting to do now with anyone that's trying to come through terminal. So what you can do is you can go top 3rd and you can wall bang this cross over here. A lot of teams are starting to do that in, you know, search and destroy and hardpoint, but it's just really easy to start wall banging it from that top 3rd. And you can just get anyone's help on time. So, you know, you might even be double channeling it like Seattle is here, and it's a good play. And now you have that extra reinforcement where he's not even towards the hill, but he can just wall bang and still help you guys out there and put some damage output there. So as you see now, after they get this final kill on Dan, that's just a huge first wave of kills for Seattle, because that's going to make sure that they have, you know, 43 seconds left on this old time going into a really big money hill in Burger Hill, which means that most of the time LAT isn't going to be trying to go for another full decent push with their entire team. So this is just going to be, you know, them trying to pick apart anyone that might be trying to fight for some scrap time while they can also rotate to that burger time as well. So it's kind of like a free 40 seconds if you can just win, you know, one more gunfight on this old hill. You know, number 3 is looking like he can make some sort of play here where he can just sneak around, find some sort of gap, maybe get this guy off old time so that they don't fully hold that last 35 seconds. And it's a good play because if you can, you know, limit this last 35 seconds for Seattle and your team is already rotated towards Burger Hill, you're really limiting the amount of points that Seattle can score here. So, you know, this is not a bad play by Cammy, just trying to fight some type of sneaky one-on-one on old. If he can win it, that's great. If not, you know, he's just going to spawn up back with his team, who's already going to be in prime position to start holding this Burger Hill. But as you see, the rest of his team is already looking towards this new hill, making sure that, you know, let's say if number 5 Kyler was already pushing towards P1, they were accounting for that. So they're going to try and make sure, you know, even at 40 seconds, their rotation to this is pretty clean because they want to make sure that they can hold P4 to P5. You know, if they can chain those two hills, they'll 100% win the game because they're already at 193. All you need to do is get, you know, 57 points out of those two hills. So they're banking on winning off one of those two hills. So we'll see this fight on old time. And this is just a huge fight for Seattle. If Seattle die here, it's going to put themselves in a really awkward position because not only does LAT have this old time, if Cammy wins this gunfight over here, and if he has some support with number four Afro, who's over here, let's say he wins a gunfight on number seven here. Now they have two guys at new while also having, you know, Joe Deceives already playing inside Burger Town. So they can technically get up to like 220 points if they win this one single gunfight here on number six. So this is actually a really big gunfight, and they see that he's contesting. Number six, Abuza, calls out to number seven, Illy, who's gonna go back over towards the plane side and help him out. Unfortunately, number four is not able to get this kill. This is actually a really important gunfight. If Afro was able to win this, you know, this changes the tide of the whole entire game because, you know, number six, if he would have lost that 1v1 or even a 1v2, if Afro goes to the plane and helps towards Cammy, you know, that completely changes the course of everything because, you know, LA Thieves is now soaking the scrap time, which really should have been Seattle's. But Ender makes a good play. He gets out of that initial engagement with Afro over here, and now he's able to help Abuza on old time. They're gonna make sure that they hold this old time. You know, number five was even going back just in case something weird happened. But now, you know, 20 seconds, it's all theirs while LAT focuses on noob because they know they just wanna stay ahead in this game. They know they're gonna have to go into Burger Town with a deficit, but you know, two money hills right away, back to back. It can totally be theirs if they play this correctly. So as you see, Seattle's rotating towards this P1 side, grouping up together. They're gonna try and use all of their attacks that they have right now towards this Burger Town side. The whole big thing with Burger Town is, you know, you have this guy soaking inside that kitchen area and he just has a trophy on him, or he might have a trophy on the cross if you have two of them up at the same time, but you can just constantly get naded out of these positions. So what you want to do is try and stay alive, but also having your players on these crosses here, trying to kill anyone that might be challenging on the other side, but also limiting the amount of attacks that they throw, because if they can coordinate their attacks, you know, they're going to have more attacks than you have trophy ticks. So you're just going to always have to be either dodging nades if you're on time, or you're just going to have to be making sure that you chow these guys before they can get their attacks off. So I'll show you the rest of the setup for LAT. You have the one guy on new time, obviously. One guy's going to be watching his cross. He's throwing his trophy right now. That's Dan Ghosty. Number three is going to be watching the library push, and number four is watching the terminal push for anyone that's hitting off of this old time. So they have everything covered. They have the preferred spawns going into P4, P5, and now we're going to make sure that we can try and soak this time, because you technically we can win off of this hill if they don't contest it or get us off this time. So Joe Deceives pops a nice two piece over here. Dan Ghosty gets another kill. Again, clean wave, but once again, they're not soaking any time yet. It's still old time. So Seattle, in this case, is actually gonna die, spawn up, go back to where they just were, and they can just get some more free tacks. So dying here is not even that bad of a thing for them in this situation specifically. So what you can do here, they're just gonna group up once again. Dan Ghosty is actually in this nice little corner trying to, you know, cut off before they can really get some map positioning towards this P1. Unfortunately though, he is gonna get traded, and now once again Seattle is grouping up towards this P1. They're spawning here. The number six off old is coming off towards this area as well, and now they're just going to group up, try and tack this guy out of the hill and chow anyone on the cross. So as you can see, Joe Deceives trying to make sure he just stays alive over here. He's going to get a trophy in a second, but you see Cammy, he's trying to watch this cross. You know, they're also making sure they're covering these other areas of the map in case someone hit a pinch through books or through this hallway over here, or even through terminal. You know, technically this guy off of old could have hit it still, but you know, you're going to have number one go back and forth, making sure that he picks it up, but also helps this cross. Cammy does a good job getting two in this prone position. He gets traded out though, but you know, Joe Deceives can still help on time. Even though he's a little bit weak, he can still get some shots off while they're not expecting it, because this breaking team is focused, you know, on this cross over here. So if Joe Deceives can peek out at the right time just for a second or two, he can get some shots off, maybe get some kills, and really help his team on this hold even while he's soaking this time. So looking good so far. Clean hold from LAT. They get another kill there. Dan Ghosty gets another trophy on. He knows that, you know, they're going to be trying to attack once again because they're spawning Eskies. They're just going to line up P1, get those nades out, and try and make sure that they get this guy off time. Any white time for this breaking team is good time. So they're trying to just make sure that they get Joe Deceives off time. And, you know, you have to have those trophies to deny that. As you see, all these nades are getting blocked by this trophy, huge trophy. But unfortunately, though, you know, Dan is getting these kills on the cross, but, you know, they just don't have enough trophies. Joe Deceives dies on time because of the nades. So unfortunately, he isn't isn't able to dodge that nade. And that's just one of the bad things about holding this hill is, you know, if you don't have enough trophies and you just keep killing these guys, you know, they can keep spawning back up with more tacks. And unfortunately, you know, Joe Deceives isn't able to stay alive in this situation. That creates some white time and it creates some chaos for LAT in this specific situation. Because it's white time, that means they have to cross over the hill. And if they have to cross over the hill, that means these P1 guys are gonna be able to see them do that. So Seattle here knows that they got the guy on time. So all they have to do now is just keep this time white, make sure they're watching the cross, double chow anyone that's at these tables over here, as you see there, and just keep this time white. They don't even have to cross towards this time if they don't want to, but they still do. Unfortunately, they don't win the gunfights here. But again, LAT is still not able to get on time because of the threat of that P1 cross. So LAT is just gonna focus on new time, making sure that they get people inside of books. They're gonna try and make sure that they just hold these spawns. You know, after you die at a hill, just making sure priority is going into that P5, you're still holding the same side of the map. Unfortunately though, Cammy does hit a teammate on Afro. So that's, you know, that's a big part of this hold. You don't wanna make sure that you have someone watching this P1 push out for anyone that might be trying to push through late towards this old time. And as you can see there, you know, that's another layer of pressure that's just eliminated for the Seattle side. So now they can take a little bit more space. As you see, RC is able to get another kill there. Even though he's traded, they're able to refill this position and still maintain this map pressure. While we also look at this bottom side where Ender is also taking gunfight on number four, it's a huge kill for spawns towards this dream side, because right now Ender is contesting it. That's why number two is spawning out towards this SE side. So if, you know, Ender can win this gunfight, that's huge for this break onto this hill. Even so, he doesn't even win this gunfight, but Kyler wins a huge gunfight on new with a sub. You don't see a lot of subs on terminal right now, and he's one of those players that still uses a sub. He cameras Cammy out of time. And number six, Abuza, actually catches Dan Ghosty trying to back off. You know, Dan Ghosty was one health, as you'll see here, from that Arcee's gunfight. So he had to back down. He tries to play his life and get away, but unfortunately, Abuza is already covering this lane, so he's able to pick out Dan Ghosty for free. That means they have two kills right away on this break. They spawn low terminal because this guy is Eskies. That means they can converge on this guy towards the stream side, but also they got to watch P1. Unfortunately, you know, maybe the call out didn't come in time for that. Joe Deceives is able to get this kill by pushing through P1, but unfortunately for LAT, Seattle is on new time and they're just trying to play tight for this. You know, they know they're spawning towards this Eskies side, and you'll see off of this spawn, Abuza makes a really good play of just watching the hallway. You know, he spawns into basically a cut. You know, he can watch this hallway for his team and watch their front while they watch the back. Unfortunately for Kyler here, Joe Deceives actually wins this gunfight with a pistol, but he just gets traded right away because Ender is playing with him on time. So stacking that hill was really good and real important in that situation. Abuza was also able to get that kill front. He does get traded though, but once again, they're still playing trades. Cammy is also weak from Abuza as well. So even though Abuza did die, he's weak for Ender. Ender is able to get this trade. He chows right away because of that comm comes in. And as you see on the other side, number eight, Arcee's, is able to get this huge kill on Afro four spawns. He gets this kill. You know, number five doesn't spawn with them right away just because number four was technically still contesting in the time, but they're spawning Eskies now. They've got everyone on hill. They've covered the dream side. They know for a fact that LAT is going to be spawning towards this low plane, like terminal side, and they're going to be playing for that. As you see, number eight, Arcee's, looking for this right away. You know, number seven here, Ender's just watching his back, just making sure that, you know, they didn't have some weird spawn towards security side, because he knows number five and number six spawning Eskies are going to be able to watch his hallways from that side. So they have everything covered in this moment. You know, as you see, they're refilling, you know, this hallway side, making sure that no one can come through the front. And LAT is trying to just get some sort of pick. Arcee's is playing his life super well here. Unfortunately, he does die because, you know, he does get double chowed here and he was super weak. He does get, you know, a few kills before he does go down. But even though he does die, Seattle is able to play off this. They get some trades hallway towards here. Abuza gets a nice two piece and basically, you know, wins them the map, because now at this time, all they have to do is, you know, get 6 points. They just have to watch the front. They know that Dan Ghosty is weak because he just had that gunfight with Abuza. So now they can just watch front. You know, Ender even picks up a sub here and is just playing it from that. He kills Dan Ghosty. They also team Chow Cammy, just had to play tight for the last few seconds, and they're able to win this terminal hardpoint. They clutch up on that P5. So thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for making it to the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this VOD breakdown of the final three hills of the terminal hardpoint between these two teams. It was a really good match and a really good hardpoint. So I hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.